Zumara, mamma mia, mamma di dare. Mia mia, cosa dare, mamma mia, vengacere. Se te vogliamo pesce, io vesso vai, isso vena, se vuoi pesce, maradena. Se ci ingappa la fantasia dei pesci, io mia vecchiozza mia, la la la, pesce ritta pacca la, ue con vanno calamara già giacchetta. Second stanza. C'è una luna a mezzo mare, mamma mia, mamma di dare. Figlia mia, cosa dare, mamma mia, pensaccia tu. Se te voglia lo porzire, isso vai, isso vena, se ma scuffetta maradena. Se ci ingappa la fantasia, di scuffettia, vecchiuzza mia.
Ciao, Pythons! Welcome to Everybody Eats with Joanne Peltier. Before we get started on today's menu, I just want to say that I hope you enjoyed the last show. They aired kind of close together, and there was a little hiccup in one of them. Those of you that have seen it know, but that's not going to happen today. So what I've decided is that since I've shared recipes for Polish dinners with you, today I'd like to reach into the other half of my heritage and share an Italian recipe. So I've already gotten started a little bit because it's gonna there's a little bit more to cooking than the timing than I had anticipated. But anyways, what I wanted to say was that while I was leafing through my copy of my Sopranos family cookbook, I found I'd stuck an invitation in there to send out to the family for a dinner to celebrate the finale of the show. We watched it religiously on Sunday nights, all squashed into the den, and I would always fix afterwards or before Italian dinner. So this was going to be the big finale. But what I found was interesting, I did find the invitation, and it said, in part, in the spirit of the Sopranos, let's get together for Sunday dinner and indulge our zest for life. I actually wrote that phrase in Italian, but it's easier to write than to pronounce. We'll remember the players and the losers, many of whom were whacked. So that was like the theme of the evening. And while we did get together, we had the room all done up. We had posters, we had music, we had food. I did tell them that we may have lasagna, but I wasn't sure, but we will definitely not have Janice's vegetarian baked ziti, nor listen to any of her New Age mumbo jumbo. This is what I found kind of interesting in the book, though, because it's going to tie into tonight's menu. I was leafing through it, and I found the actual menu that I made. So on this file card, and this is what I'm going to be making tonight. I'm going to be making the cavatelli, and it tells the cavatelli, sausage, broccoli, grated cheese. For a side dish, I was going to thinking about escarole, when you could cook the escarole with garlic and oil, or escarole salad. So this was just so amazing because this is what I turned out to do for tonight, Sopranos finale. So there it is, and the date was when I was planning this meal, 6/5/2004. So that was like quite a shock to find out it was that long ago. So much for the little story behind the cavatelli, and moving on to the next thing I wanted to tell you about is I have another interesting cookbook, and this one is published by the Stinking Rose Restaurant, featuring garlic recipes. So here's the book. This was a gift to me from my daughter when she was in San Francisco, and apparently there's Gilroy's Farm in California, which is famous for producing the most garlic. But now, since I brought up garlic, we've done a little research, as is our way, and we're going to take a look at its history. It's one of the oldest food flavoring and seasoning plants, and moved from Asia, where it was first cultivated, to Egypt around 3000 BC. Royal Egyptians fed garlic to slaves who were building the pyramids in the belief that it strengthened them. It's a little ambiguous because I'm wondering if the royals thought it strengthened the pyramid or did it strengthen the slaves, but I'm pretty sure they meant the slaves. It was also used for medicinal and religious purposes. Its use spread to Rome, Greece, and Europe. It was believed to prolong life, to help heal wounds, and prevent gangrene. Before the era of modern antibiotics, garlic was widely used up to and including World Wars I and II. Research continues as scientists look at garlic for possible cures of cancer, heart disease, and arthritis. And I also have in here, these are just two things that I think you might find interesting. I selected the two things that I thought might be the most surprising. And this one is garlic cough syrup. And it's basically what you think: garlic, fennel, caraway seeds, vinegar, and sugar, and a little bit more. Let it boil, let it stand for 12 hours, so forth and so on. And actually, one of my sisters, I think, does believe in the garlic tea when she has a sore throat. The other thing, which is really going to blow your mind, is garlic ice cream. And I knew I had to show it to you because you'd think, you know, that can't possibly be. But it sounds like a legitimate recipe. Whole milk, freshly chopped garlic, only a quarter teaspoon, and then the vanilla bean, heavy cream, sugar, and egg yolks. So it sounds more like a custard. But anyhow, that's where we stand with the garlic and what we can do with the garlic. And I also just made sure, just to, you know, I really do believe in garlic in my cooking. Unfortunately, not all of us can tolerate it, but I do like to have it. So I'm just trying to move on here a little bit. And I did start cooking the sausage already because I have so much of it, but I saved a few pieces. Let me just rinse my hands off here. I saved a few pieces of the sausage just so I can show you. You probably already know how to do this, but I figured I'd show you anyway. If you end up with the sausages like this, this was a full tray, and then this is the one that's already loose in a package, a little square package. So you just split it, and it's easy enough to do, you know, to get it. And I did start it sooner over here just to get a head start on some of this, because once you get going with the Cavatelli, it cooks up in no time. So I wanted to get a little head start on all of this. And I'm just going to do this other sausage. I'm taking the skin off. That's right. I'm taking the skin off. And that's why if you're really in a hurry, you buy it in the package where it's loose. Not loose, but they square it off. But if you're Italian, sweet sausage. And you can also put the hot sausage in here, too. We're not big fans of the hot sausage. So I'm sticking only with the sweet. This is 2 pounds of sausage. If I'm making it for a bigger group, I would probably use 3 pounds, depending on the amount of people. But today, I'm just using the 2 pounds. And believe me, it's going to be more than enough for our menu. So, see how I'm, I don't know if you can see what I'm doing here, just trying to brown it all up. And I'm glad we started it a little early, so we wouldn't have to stay here and wait for the whole thing to be done. And I'm going to add some garlic to this. In fact, I'm going to throw some in on the other side. We need to break this piece up. And throw some garlic in on the other side. And this is a very easy recipe.
and it does serve a crowd. I have a gigantic lasagna pan, and it will fill it up. Because once you put this, you do this, you put the garlic, I'm going to put chicken broth, and then the chicken broth, and then you're going to do the Cavatelli pasta, and a lot of broccoli. But right now I'm going to throw the garlic in and get this going. And then after this all cooks down, I am going, can you save this in the frying pan? Because I can tip it over if you want. Here we go. Can you see it now? And as I said before, you don't need a lot of pots and pans. If you have like a nice good sized cast iron pan like this, if this kind of pan does double duty, this will do so much work for you, it's unbelievable. And I really use it a lot. I'm actually thinking if you want, we could just stop for a few minutes and I can finish cooking this up before we resume. So, did that work for you?
Here.
We're back in business here. Everything is cooking. Oh my goodness, look at that though. The garlic is turning too brown. Oh boy. Oh boy. I'm going to have to move those babies. You don't want your garlic like that, brown, too brown. But I'll save it. Yeah. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put in some of my low-sodium chicken broth right now to bring it down the temperature. And I'm only going to use, like right now, I'm going to use a half of this. So this is a quart, which would be 4 cups. So I'm only going to use half of it. So that'll be 2 cups. But this is going to be nice because that sausage and the garlic and all of that. We're going to flavor each other up. That feels about right. I don't really have a magic eye to see through it, but it feels right. But I did do, as I said, 2 pounds of sausage. This is a quart. We're going to add this more to this later if we need it. And this is at a good boil now, so I'm going to take that cover and put it on here. And I actually think I'm going to push this back to the back burner now so that I can have more room up front here on the stove. And I'll just put this back here on a simmer. So that basically takes about, that probably took about 20 minutes maybe to cook the sausage, you know, with the, now I put the broth in so it's still going to flavor. If I had done this earlier, I would let it sit all day maybe, you know, in the seasonings, then if I just heat it up at supper time. But, or if you take it to a gathering, it's perfect reheated. I just save some of the broccoli to the very end to make sure it's nice and bright to put on. So I'm going to pull this pan back over here because that's going to be for the broccoli and for the cavatelle. This is what I use. It's with the ricotta cheese in it. And I'm going to put a little oil in the water. These caps are kind of weird, so I always like to make sure no air gets in. So I'm just going to put a little oil in there so it doesn't stick. And I'll just put this over here for now. You see, what's sitting over here waiting to go with the dinner. Don't make a mistake and drink that one. And so... I'm going to just dump this in. And as I said, I have 2 bags, and these cook really, really quickly. It says like 7 to 8 minutes. And they float up just like you, like on your ravioli, when you do your ravioli. So let me just try to get these in without burning myself. Bag number one. And I'm gonna put bag number two. This is more than we really need right now, but I guess I could put 1.5 bags, because that's what I sometimes do, just put 1.5. But I'll put the two. You know what? Once the kids find out that I made this, I've already planned on giving them, you know, containers to take home anyway. So I'll just do the two full bags. And we'll be sending some home tomorrow. Also, we're going to be having a get-together for Memorial Day. So I'll be in this kitchen tomorrow, starting super early with some... Well, let me just make sure this in the back is okay. Oh, yeah. But I'll start first thing. I'm going to boil up the potatoes for potato salad. I probably shouldn't be talking about two different things, but it doesn't matter. I have the red potatoes for potato salad. And deviled eggs. I'm going to boil up my eggs for deviled eggs. And I have my potato salad now is a combination of the way my mom used to make it and Bob's mom used to make it. So we never had green peppers in ours. So I added the green peppers from like what she used to do. And we used to put shredded carrots, which I'm not so sure my mother-in-law did. So I have like a hybrid potato salad. And then the deviled eggs, definitely, I learned from my mother-in-law. What else am I gonna have? Oh, I have chicken, which I'm just gonna bake it in the oven and then put the barbecue sauce on just before serving. I have hot dogs. I got those nice ones in the natural casing. And, what else? Oh, I just went out and bought the spare ribs. And I think it was a gigantic package, you know? So we're going to have a lot of food. And there again, those, my friend told me how she cooks hers. Wrap it in tinfoil, season it. Wrap it in tinfoil, throw it in the oven, like at 325, and leave it go for a couple hours. And then, you know, take it out, uncover it, and just put the barbecue sauce on and either throw it back in the oven or under the broiler, or if you have a grill, throw it on the grill. But right now I think I'm just going to be using the oven. A lot of times when the grill gets going, I always ask my son to do all the barbecuing, and I just thought tomorrow we'll just try to use the oven if possible, and that way my husband doesn't have to clean up the grill either and get all that stuff going. So right now we're going to wait for these to come to a boil. The other thing I'm going to do is broccoli. And I had a choice which vegetable did I want to highlight on this today. And I could have highlighted broccoli, but I chose to do the garlic because I thought it's really hard to find something too interesting about broccoli. So I'm gonna put in probably half of this bag into the pot. Let's see here. These are big too. These are the florets. Let me see how many pounds is here. 4 pounds. So half of that's be 2 pounds. So yeah, that's pretty good. You got 2 pounds of sausage. You got about, I don't know, 4 pounds of pasta. And now you're gonna have 4 pounds of 2 pounds of broccoli. So that all works. I think that looks like enough. Those are big. You know, I wish you could talk to me. I wish my audience could talk to me. Oh well, I'll just talk to myself and you guys, which is fine. All right, this I'm just gonna pop in the fridge for now. Oh, what else I'm having tomorrow is corn on the cob. Yes, corn on the cob. And let's see here. Oh, if I can even fit this in. Yeah, there's the hot dogs. It's gonna be quite a feast. Oh, and I bought cherries and a watermelon and black cherry ice cream, which my granddaughters absolutely love. So it's all about trying to find food that everybody enjoys. And I'll, of course, make a little batch of mac and cheese. The side dishes are important, especially with youngsters. And so that's pretty, oh yeah, so we're gonna have the ice cream, the watermelon, the cherries, and I just put it in the wrong one. You put it in this one. All right, and now that it's starting to come to a boil, I'm gonna set my timer for 7 minutes. this isn't that important if you don't get it cooked all the way, especially if you're going to save it for later. It doesn't have to be totally done, because you don't want it mushy either. So you kind of just use your judgment. I mean, nobody's a stranger to the kitchen, right? You know your, you know how your people like their, if they like it really tender or mushy, the pasta. But when you're first starting to make something, I do suggest trying to follow the recipe. I've been looking at some new recipes that, oh my God, I can't wait to start trying some of these new recipes. And I might even be brave and try them on, you know, right now with you to let you see how they come out. But I do know one of the next recipes I want to make is going to be, this isn't going to be new, this is something I make all the time. Sausage and spinach bread, and it's a crowd pleaser. So, and I know when some of, whoops, geez, that's going up kind of high. All right. The sausage and spinach bread is a real crowd pleaser. And I don't use it as an appetizer. I make them big and full of food and serve it with a salad. That's your meal, you know? That's your meal. So, now we have to wait 7 minutes. I don't know. I'm going to be able to talk to you and keep you interested for 7 minutes. Oh, well. Oops. Right. That's right. We did open with the Mama Leone's menu. And way back when my husband and I were dating, and we had some other friends, and we'd all get together, and we'd go to New York. And we would get dressed up. In those days, people did get dressed up. You know, the girls wore coats and high heels, and the guys wore sports jackets and such. And we'd go to the Empire State Building and use the camera there, or the thing to look out, the telescope. And then we'd do a little bit of more sightseeing around New York, and then we'd end up at Mama Leone's for dinner. And it was like, wow, so fantastic. So Bob and I continue to enjoy going there and for dinner on occasions. And then they did move from their original location. The original location is really, this is like really was what they had, the marble, they had the statues in there, waiters, all kinds of like the Italian music. It was really quite beautiful. And you could get a prefix dinner. And it tells you here what, you know, you could, some of your choices were. And then they had the different times for you to come in. But you could also go in after the theater, because they were in the theater district. So you'd go in after the theater and have a late supper. Fast forward 20 years, and we go there to celebrate our anniversary. And my husband presented me with a lovely ring. And the guys at work said it was, will you marry me again ring. And so we had a nice dinner, and he asked the waiter if we could take the menu. And he also, they have these angel wings. They're like, I'm sure you've had them. They're fried and they shake a powdered sugar all over them. So we got a bag of those to go. So then my thoughtful husband had this framed for me, and it's been in my kitchen for so many years. I just love it. And I had a goal of trying to make all the food on the menus, which I have not done, I have to admit. But hopefully life is long, and I might get through a lot of that, or at least a good portion of it. But anyways, that's the story on the Mama Leone's. But we always did enjoy going there, and that's a lot of the Italian food there. So anyways, my broccoli is not coming up yet to boil, but these are. So, and I did set the timer, okay. Boy, this really could be a really quick meal for you too. The only thing is with your sausage, you need to make sure the pork is well done. That's the whole thing. But I actually think by putting in the chicken broth, you know, that definitely makes sure that your sauce is well done, your meat's well done, because it's got all that broth. But the broccoli is still taking a little time. I don't want it to boil over either. I did so much cooking recently, the stove was a disaster. And you know who had to do it, clean it, and it wasn't me.
I always hate to mess it up, but it seems like the day after it gets cleaned, I want to make hamburgers or something, you know? Anyways, I have one more thing about the garlic. This little guy, you've probably seen him. This is you can roast garlic in here. And what you would do is take the whole bulb, and you'd cut off the, can I get them out? Yeah. You cut off the top a little bit and the bottom, pick all the extra paper off, drizzle oil over it, put it on, put the cover on, put it in the oven, and let it go for like, I don't know, hour or so, maybe 325, 350. But when you buy these, you usually come in a little box, and it will give you all the instructions on it, how to use it. The funny story about this is, I thought that I lent it out, and I didn't get it back. So I said, gee, I don't think you gave me back my garlic roaster. And so I got a replacement, you know. Well, when my daughter and I were cleaning out the pantry, not only did I find this one, but I found the brand new replacement. So I had to come forward and tell my son that he did give it back to me. And I gave him the new one. But he was like, sometimes, you know, you get a little embarrassed, but it's a nice little item to have if you like to roast your garlic, because then you can squeeze out the softened garlic, little pieces of garlic, and put it on your bread, you know, with some butter. Okay, this guy is going off, and the broccoli hasn't done yet, so I think we can just take another little break, if you don't mind, while I finish this, and then we'll come back and we'll do the wrap-up. You see all that? Yeah.
And now for you nice ladies and gentlemen out there who don't understand the Italian language, I'd like to do two choruses in British. Lazy Mary, you better get up. She answered back, I am not able. Lazy Mary, you better get up. We need the sheets for the table. Lazy Mary, you smoke in bed. There's only one man you should marry. My advice to you would be is to pay attention to me.
I love it.
You'd better marry a fireman. He'll come and go, go and come. Zembala boom bamada there. Sitting up a la banda, see it, a bombardier, a big desire. La 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 la, we should make the bucka.
I love that song. I don't think I ever heard the English part, and I don't speak Italian, so. Oh my God. Anybody else want to come over to eat? Look at all of this. This is what happened with the Gwapkis, remember? I think I'm cooking for all these people. I make so much food. But anyways, that's your Cavatelli. That's what it should look like. And here's the rest of it. So it does make a lot, so now you know. If you want to make a lot, use two full bags. And the first time out, you might just want to make one bag just in case you don't like it. Well, I think you'll like it, but. I think maybe start with the one bag, you know. One bag of this, 2 pounds of sausage, 2 pounds of, or 1 pound of broccoli. Well, bag, you do the 2 pounds of broccoli, you know, that's good. And, but maybe, depends how many people you want to feed. So I'm just going to put it in here. I should be having a fancier bowl. I didn't expect it to make so much in this right now, but it did. Well, usually, too, when I do this, if I'm going to bring it to someplace, I have a really, really large lasagna pan, and it just fills it up nicely.
In fact, I want to make lasagna and for the show. But as I said, my pan is so big. When I make it, even though there's 8 of us here eating it, even after that, it still can. Everybody gets to take home quite a bit. So it's like I ended up buying 2 smaller lasagna pans so I can make them for the show. So that's coming up. But the broccoli looks pretty good, no? Oh, I'm going to put that in last because I don't want it to get squashed. So now I'm going to put the sausage. And most of this, again, it's kind of trial and error, you know? Just see what you think. But, you know, I do go to the gym, so good Lord, this is heavy. But, enough. Actually, Bob doesn't see a lot of stuff that goes on in the kitchen, so I think he's getting quite a surprise here of everything that goes on. One day, I was in the kitchen, and everybody was over, and everybody's in the other room, and talking, and laughing, and all that business, and having a nice time, because I'm out here, and I needed to get this strainer, this one right here, and it's up here, you know, up here, so I've learned to use various tools that I have, you know, to get stuff, but I did that, and clunk, right on the head. Like, one of my granddaughters come out, and she goes, Babchi, are you okay? I said, oh, you heard that, huh? But anyways, there's a lot of fun goes on in the kitchen. A lot of activity. And as I say, you spend so much of your time in here cooking. Now here goes the broccoli. And, oh, I forgot to put the grated cheese. Well, I'll put the grated cheese in now. I'll toss it a little bit. And the other thing is really important is to use really, really good grated cheese. My daughter gets this for me at a big store. I don't know if you're supposed to say their names or not, but I get a big, big bag of it. And it's Romano mixed with something else. And it's really delicious. And I actually just put everything into a smaller jar, like in that way it stays fresh. The bag is a big bag. And I keep it in the fridge. And, but what do you think? This is pretty much what your meal's gonna look like. You can add more broccoli, less broccoli. The recipe that I actually found this in the newspaper, but like everything else, when you cook, you make it your own. And they talked about using hot pepper flakes, and I don't do that. But as I say, sometimes I might put one or two hot peppers in there. Not pepper, hot sausage. But I'm not really too keen on that. So sometimes I'll just make some hot sausage on the side for those that want to jazz it up a little bit. But I actually think at this point, I'm going to throw the rest of these in. I think I've given you all pretty much the amounts. And if you find when you're going to reheat it, it's dry. If you're going to like reheat it in the oven or in the microwave or on the stove, use your chicken broth. But, you know, keep it nice and moist. And I guess we should take a little taste right now. I did put the plates out just so we could try it. And just put one over here. Let's see here. And for all the years I do this, I still... Okay. Nope. Let me think for a second. Yeah. Yeah, left fork on the left, right? Okay, and then I get a nice big spoon in case you want a spoon. And I do want to try this. I'll just take a quick little bite. You don't have to try it, honey, if you don't want to, all right? And, well, you'll get it for supper, it's your supper, but I just want to take a quick little taste. As I say, the cook always should taste your food. And they do recommend, like, when you watch Julia Childs, she's constantly about, you know, you taste it, you know what I mean? And any other people that cook, you know, on these, I don't want to just get all broccoli, I want some of the other stuff. I'm just going to take it a quick taste and see how it came out. I'm hoping it's good. Oh yeah, see how quick this was? Mm-hmm.
until I make sure the sausage is done. Mmm. It's very good. You can use whatever brand you want. You know, whatever you choose. You can use, we have a Italian market, you can get special sausage from them. You can use chicken sausage. There's a whole kinds of, you can just personalize it. But anyways, did you get a good picture of this? Yeah? Okay. Now, as usual, I want to say thank you. And I hope you enjoyed the show. Thank you for watching. And a special thank you to my researcher and my editor. And some of the stuff I really prepare to say, you'd be here all night. So he's a very good editor and researcher and videographer. But anyways, I want to say thank you very much. And I want to share this with you. And are you ready to see this? Are you seeing it? Well, that's so lovely. So thank you. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the show. Are you seeing it?